Hello there, ladies and gents. Welcome to another video by The Exhausted Man. Now this video will be quite short and I won't be really showing my face over here, or I won't be showing my face at all. So hopefully you guys will enjoy and hopefully stay tuned to the video. Now if there's one particular genre that I'm really addicted to watch and at the same time pretty hurtful as well, is the harem genre in anime, which is the Battle of the Waifus. Now, basically, a harem genre is where they put a bunch of waifus in this one show and they have to fight in order to become best girl in that show, and they shall be picked by the protagonist. I've seen some very good waifus here. There's the tsundere waifu, there's the derere waifu, there's the shy type kind of waifu, and there's also the waifu in which we thought was best girl, but in the end, got rejected.
No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
And if you guys haven't known, I've been watching this one particular anime and I'm really, really addicted to its plot, and I just can't stop going for the next episode. And this anime actually got me into binging into the manga, and I've reached to the latest chapter and here I am waiting for an eternity to wait for each chapter. And that particular anime is called This anime starts off by introducing us to Kazuya, who just got dumped by his girlfriend after a 1 month relationship, and he feels very depressed and very, very low at this point. So he found a very, very unhealthy solution, which is renting a girlfriend. As he rented the girlfriend and meet up at the place, we are then introduced to the very godly waifu here, which is Chizuru Mizuhara. And they went on a date together. They had some kind of unprotected hand-holding. Whoa, that is hot. They talk, they laugh, they went out for they went out like how a couple should be. But then at the end, very end of the day, Kazuya realized that how she acted towards him is just the same thing as how she acted to her other clients. I mean, shouldn't he be expecting this, because she's just a girlfriend for rent? But then Kazuya got really mad and got really pissed off, because he thought that this girl is somewhat two-faced. I don't know, so I'm not sure if it's the next day or next week, but all I know is that he rented her a second time. And then just right inside the aquarium in the public, he literally called her off and said that she's just a two-faced, I don't know, he's just exposing her and stuff like that. And I mean, at this moment I was like, bruh, what would you expect, bro? I mean, literally, they just main protagonist Kazuya is just, I just can't with him. I mean, even having a conversation with him, it'll be really awkward, and I would just call him as some kind of a-hole, you know. So yeah, right after that, things got worse, because people start thinking that he's actually dating with his rental girlfriend, and even his family thought that he's dating with his rental girlfriend as well. So yeah, basically this anime is about how this guy's life is really messed up in each episode. And if you think about it, it's actually pretty much his fault. But there's something very addictive about this anime that just kept me watching and even been binging through the manga. Now let's be real here. Kazuya is not a bad person. He is not irredeemable, but he's just very, very flawed. By watching the anime and reading the manga, you just don't know how much bruh moments I've been with this guy. I mean, literally, his motivations can be very questionable, and like, his actions are just very dumb. But well, no matter how much times I've I just see him as a very silly person. I sometimes can relate to this guy. I mean, there are times when I feel very stupid and I've done silly things that made me feel really pathetic. So I really do feel this guy sometimes, just sometimes. Maybe probably not stalking your crush, but yeah, you get my point. In the manga and also in the anime, there are some redeemable moments that he has done, but it has not led up to that part where it actually covers up to his mistakes. So he's not there yet, but he's getting there. So I'm rooting for him because Chizuru Mizuhara, she is like the grand prize for him. And at this part, I'm gonna talk more about Chizuru Mizuhara. Now, Chizuru Mizuhara isn't just best girl in this show, but also best girl for this year. Period. I mean, there's something very much different than my other waifus about her. And what I feel about this is that she's an SSR rated top tier waifu, but at the same time, she feels very much real, as in like she's like a real person. Now, don't get me wrong about this, that the best waifu out there has very great traits that just wouldn't work in real life. Because, well, they're anime characters. I am deeply in love with Haruhi Suzumiya in The Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya, but if she were to be real in real life, I would just slap her on how many times she's just very, very much annoying. And I love Himiko Toga from My Hero Academia because she's a psychopathic maniac, but I wouldn't like her in real life because she's a psychopathic maniac. Some people say that Chizuru Mizuhara is a tsundere type. There are moments that she's like a tsundere. I do agree, but however, she's mad at reasonable things. She's a matured grown woman. If she feels something is wrong, she'll just call you off as like a genuine human being. And if she's mad, it won't be that long. But the most important thing about Mizuhara is that she'll stick with you and she actually gets you. So like, I'm really rooting for these both, to be honest, even though for now Kazuya is just very unbearable and he doesn't deserve her yet, but I am truly rooting for them both to be together because the best girl deserves the best boy. Now, other things that I want to talk about this anime and the manga, one of the characters, Ruka-chan, she is, well, second in line. Don't get mad, okay, Ruka fans. I do like her, okay? I do like her. I would even go on a date with her. But, you know, you gotta admit, I mean, she probably initially had blue hair because she is now at the rejected squad right there. Yeah, sorry bro, sorry. Then right after this we have Sumi-chan. Yes, this girl is just she's a shy one. She's a very shy one, but she's just, oh my god, I just can't wait for her to be in this anime because I've been reading the manga and they've been showing a lot about her and she's just really, really cute. And did you guys know that the voice actor for her is also the voice actor for Megumin? You know, the one that says, so yeah, pretty ironic for a loud person like Megumin to be voicing this very, very cute and shy girl. And also by reading manga, you manga readers probably know that they already introduced to a new girl in that manga, which is the E-girl. I forgot her name, but she's a pretty cool character, so I can't wait for her to be in the anime. Okay, that's about it. Wait, what? Mami-chan? Let me show you just how much I feel about this character here.
You don't want to be like this. This is disgusting. This is awful in every way. If I could kill it, I would. But I legally can't. But I've considered it. Ah! Good God! It's hideous. But beautiful in an ugly way. But mostly hideous. Ugh. Now the main problem area is up here, All of this going on up here is what's causing me the most physical discomfort. It's like a visceral reaction of discontent coming from this area. This area is not good either. I hate this, but I'm mainly worried about this. I win.